And getting ready to begin with Group A Super Late Model Time Trials. And he was able to make repairs of that car. See the number 7 out of Oakdale, Tennessee. That's Derrick York in a CVR race car with a Phantom Racing engine sponsored by the Tennessee Punch Bunch, Brownlow Customs, and Turpin's Auto. He'll be joined by the 201 out of Knoxville, Tennessee, former multi-time Tazewell Speedway track champion, Billy Ogle Jr. in the Vanover Racing Longhorn with a custom sponsored by Harrison Ready Mix and Vanover and Sons Concrete. And a first lap time for York will be a 17.077, and he's into the wall up in turn number 1 and 2 again. 17.0, and we'll let Billy Ogle, he'll be coming, looks like, to the white flag. And we'll be getting the white flag here on the 201 of Billy Ogle Jr. And he'll go 16.656, or 16.659, 16.659 on lap one for Billy Ogle Jr. In the 201, the Vanover Racing Longhorn working off turn number 4. Down to complete his second and final lap. He'll go a 16.890, 16.890. So his first lap going to be the mark to beat right now at 16.659. So our next two qualifiers out, see the number 7 had a top 5 finish at Talladega Short Track earlier this season at the Ice Bowl. Barberville, Kentucky's Brian Smith in a Capital race car sponsored by Smith Guttering and Siding, Harry Central's Family Salon, Smith Ceiling and Razor's Edge. And he'll be joined by another Kentucky driver, the 97 Ponderosa Speedway 2016 track champion, Michael Chilton. First lap time for Brian Smith, he goes 16.535, 16.535, top of the leaderboard. New quick time right there, Michael Chilton at 16.362 on lap number 1 for Michael Chilton. Lap 2 for Brian Smith, 16.702, and Michael Chilton down in the Caton Industrial Painting, Chilton Lawn and Maintenance, Parkview Home Center Dial Painting Machine. And his second lap will be 16.426, 16.426, Chilton 16.362, the mark to beat right now. We get our next two qualifiers out. The Winterfest runner-up last weekend in the A-19 out of Cleveland, Tennessee, John Ownbey and a Masterbuilt with a Vincent race engine sponsored by Austin Trucking, Coons Plumbing, and Tindall & Son Carpentry. And he's joined by the number 30 out of Seymour, Tennessee, and a Warrior with a Phantom race engine. That's Ryan King. First lap time for Ownbey. He'll clock in 15.693, 15.693. And that's your new quick time. Ryan King, 16.826, 16.826 King, and the Brian King Roofing, Jim Sands Roofing, High Velocity Heads Up, Parton's Barbecue, Sponsored Machine, Ownbey, 16.892, 16.892. And the second lap of 4, Ryan King, 16.482, and John Ownbey, top of the leaderboard at 15.693 right now. As our next two qualifiers out, see the 1A out of Cumberland Furnace, Tennessee. That's Levi Ashby in a Rocket with a B&B Performance engine. The Wheel Shop, Tommy's Quality Used Cars, Wheels to Go, K&F Gas and Fabrication. He's joined by the one of Shane Bailey out of Grayson, Kentucky, in a Masters Bill with an SB Customs engine, sponsored by SB Customs, Action Tire, Wolf Ricker Service, and Gun Gold and Cash. First lap time for Ashby. He'll clock in at 16.795, 16.795. First lap time for Bailey, 17.278, 17.278 for Bailey on lap number 1. Lap number 2 coming up for Levi Ashby. He'll go 16.695, 16.695. And lap number 2 for Shane Bailey. He'll go a 17.437, 17.437. As we get ready to go with our next two qualifiers, see the number 87 out of Chatsworth, Georgia, Andrew Littleton on a TNT race car with a Phillips race engine, Littleton General Construction, Rogersville Ice, UST Suspension, Adams Automotive and Performance, and Finish Line Race Products. And he's joined by the two of Seymour, Tennessee's Mitchell Childress and a Barry Wright with NRE engine, sponsored by King and Machine Welding, FK Rod-Ins, and King Chassis Works. First lap time on the 87 of Andrew Littleton. He'll go a 16.888, 16.888. And Mitchell Childress goes to 16.477, 16.477. And Littleton on his second lap, 16.655, 16.655. And Childress's second lap, 16.824, 16.824. I believe we got just a couple of cars remaining. And the first one rolling out, he won the Cabin Fever 40 down at Boyd Speedway at the end of January in the 50 out of Morristown, Tennessee. The Double Down Motorsports Longhorn Vic Hill powered machine for Shannon Buckingham in the Fleetwood RV, Tennessee RV Super Center, Grade A Design Recreational Vehicles Classic 100.5 WIMZ sponsored machine. And he'll be joined by the driver of the K-37 out of North City, Tennessee, the Longhorn of Mike Weeks, sponsored by Superior Telecom and Schubert Monuments. First lap time for Buckingham, 16.542, 16.542. Mike Weeks, he'll go with 16.345, 16.345. Buckingham, his second lap coming up, he'll go a 16.609, 16.609. And the second lap time for Mike Weeks, he'll go a 16.438, 16.438. And the final car in Group A rolling out in the number seven, former Hangover winner here at 411 Motor Speedway and the Blunt Motorsports Rocket with the McHill race engine out of Austinville, Georgia. It's D. Mac, Donald McIntosh, and the Massey Electric Stires Cat, Blunt Motorsports, Arnold's Trucking, Tennessee RV Super Center, Cherokee Millwright, DNR Investment sponsored machine. First lap time coming up for McIntosh. He'll go 16.284, 16.284 at his second quick in this group. So far, again, the top eight locked in. Right now it's Buckingham, Smith, King, Chilton, or Childress, Chilton, Weeks, McIntosh. McIntosh goes 16.098, 16.098. Your eight locked in out of Group A. John Ownbey at 15.693. Then Donald McIntosh, Mike Weeks, Michael Chilton, Mitchell Childress, Ryan King, Brian Smith, Shannon Buckingham. Those are your lock-in cars out of Group A. As we get ready to go with Group B, see the number three out of Asheville, North Carolina. This is Floyd Self out of GRT with a Milton Wolf race engine. And he's going to be joined by the defending Frostbuster winner out of Loudoun, Tennessee, Cory Hedgecock. And it'll be won by Bruce Bill with an Eagle race engine, the Smithfield Homes Renegade Race Fuels, Campy Used Cars, Cushman, Rebel Diesel, Voodoo Technologies, Bruce Bill Performance Sponsored Machine, Floyd Self. He goes a 16.905, 16.905. Cory Hedgecock goes 16.213, 16.213 on lap one for Cory Hedgecock. And Floyd Self goes 16.796, 16.796. His second lap, 16.011, 16.011. So Hedgecock fastest in this group at this point. Next two qualifiers rolling out. The Winterfest winner last weekend in the 29 out of Maryville, Tennessee. The Longhorn BMB Performance Powered Machine for Jason Welshan out of Maryville, Tennessee. The Hitting Auto Motorsports CNJ Trucking Competition Racing Equipment Sexton Construction Sponsored Machine. He'll be joined by the 117 of Science Hill, Kentucky's Jimmy Smith. And a Revolution with a crate GM 604, the Don Franklin Family of Dealerships, Gerald's Auto Parts. Next Gen Mechanical, Todd Metals Sponsored Machine. Welshan's first lap, 15.824. Fastest in this group now, 15.824. Jimmy Smith, 16.864, 16.864. And Welshan, his time of 15.616. 15.616, that's quick time overall now. And quick time for the group. Jimmy Smith, second lap, 17.933, 17.933. Next two qualifiers rolling out in the 31. The Tazewell Speedway regular out of Ewing, Virginia. This is Dakotah Knuckles and a Longhorn with a Vic Hill engine sponsored by Estes Construction and Boone's BP Fuel. He'll be joined by the veteran in the 11B out of Clinton, Tennessee, the Capital Race Car Vic Hill powered machine for Stacy Boles, the Advanced Transportation, Advanced Auto Sales, Kaiser Manufacturing, West Haven Speed Equipment, Outlaw Graphics, Competition Racing Equipment sponsored machine. Dakotah Knuckles, he'll go a 16.016, 16.016. What's it? 16.246, 16.246. Knuckles, 16.170, 16.170. And 16.115 for Stacy Bowles, 16.115. Next two qualifiers out. In the 102 out of Dakota, Georgia, that's Clayton Turner, the Masters built with a Gabriel's race engine, the Carolina Performance Anchorage Marine Rocket Construction, Rayburn Alternator sponsored machine. He's joined by the veteran in the 3 out of Powell, Tennessee, the CJ Rayburn Phantom Race Engines Powered Machine, Rick Welsh Racing, Hoosier Tire sponsored for Steve Smith out of Powell, Tennessee. First lap time for Clayton Turner. He goes to 16.542, 16.542. Steve Smith goes 16.121, 16.121. And Turner, his second lap, 16.395, 16.395. Lap number two for Steve Smith. He'll clock in at 16.257, 16.257. In a 69 out of Salem, Virginia, the young man, 12 years of age, that is Carter Miller, in a Rocky with a Baton Built race engine to Irwin Racing Supply, Brickwood Builders, River Rock, Miller Brothers Racing, Black Bull Racing, Kofel Graphics, Dirty Diesel sponsor machine. He's joined by the 19 of a young man out of Iville, Kentucky, James Williamson, and a Swartz with a Williamson race engine. First lap time for Carter Miller. He'll go 16.427, 16.427 Williamson in the East Hills Heating, Huggies Diesel, Martha's Pizza, Custom Suspension, Williams Custom Fabrication, sponsor machine. Williams goes 17.311, 17.311. Floyd Self on the bubble right now. He is in the show as we stand right now. Carter Miller, 16.244. Put Miller into position number six here in Group B. And Williamson, much better, 16.628, 16.628. And James Williamson now goes to the A spot, so he is the bubble car. Next two qualifiers out, see the 17. The veteran out of Loudoun, Tennessee, and I say veteran, he's young in age, been racing for several years. That's Matt Henderson in the Terror Race Cars house car with an Eagle Race engine sponsored by five-star Hyundai, Jerry Duncan Ford, and Crowder Small Engines. And he's going to be joined by the 21, the Double Down Motorsports Rocket, Vic Hill Powered Machine of Maryville, Tennessee's Robby Moses in the 21. First lap time for Matt Henderson, 16.586, 16.586 for Henderson. First lap time for Moses, 16.655, 16.655. Moses, the Tennessee RV Supercenter, Grand Day Design, Recreational Vehicles, Classic Rock 103.5 WIMZ, Hard Rock Cafe, Smoky Mountain Speedway, sponsor machine. Henderson, good lap, 16.150. Put Henderson into the sixth spot now. Robby Moses, 16.587, 16.587. It looks like the last qualifier out in the 7G machine, the veteran in a rocket chassis out of Cleveland, Tennessee. That is Craig Greer. Craig Greer and the EcoPest sponsored number 7G. And he'll come down and trip the timing device at 18.218, 18.218 on lap one for Cleveland, Tennessee native Craig Greer in the 7G. And a final time by for Craig Greer. He'll go 17.481, 17.481. So your top eight locked in Group B. Your top eight in Group B, Jason Welshan, fastest at 15.616, and he's also the overall fast qualifier. Cory Hedgecock, second. Dakotah Knuckles, third. Stacy Boles, fourth. Steve Smith, fifth. Matt Henderson, sixth. Carter Miller, seventh. And Clayton Turner, eighth. Those eight out of Group B also locked in. And the field getting the one to go signal. Ten laps in the top six, going to race their way on to the Frostbuster 40. Everyone else will be done for the afternoon. As we get set to bring them to green, Andrew Littleton in the 87 and the 21 of Robby Moses. Eyes on him at the white chalk line off turn four. Green flags out. Here we go. Moses with a good start. He'll lead the field down into turn number one. Littleton's going to be second. Three wide for third. Billy the Kid, the meat and the sandwich between Levi Ashby and James Williamson. And look at Levi Ashby. He'll come out of there with the third spot, trying to get second from Littleton. But Littleton will close the door on him in turns three and four. And we got a car spun toward the back of the field. That's going to be the one of Shane Bailey. Top six going to transfer. Littleton and Moses will try it again here off turn number four. Green flag waves. Here we go. Moses again with a good start, leads the field off into turn number one, and Littleton's going to be second. Ogle, he's going to be on the bottom this time with a good run off the bottom side of turn two. He'll go to third. Levi Ashby and James Williamson go side by side for fourth and fifth. Asheville, North Carolina's Floyd Self sits in that sixth and final transfer spot at this point. As Moses shows the way, Littleton second, Ogle and Williamson still going at it for third and fourth. Ashby closes in now to try to make it a three-way dance for that third position down into turn number three.
Ogle and Williamson drift up, may open the door for Ashby. Nope, they'll not get it done right there. Yes, Moses leads Littleton off turn two down the back straightaway, but Williamson going to step tiptoe to the outside on the black slick racing surface here, 4-1-1. And he'll grab the third position away from Billy Ogle Jr. And now Ashby starts to put some pressure on Billy the Kid for that fourth position down in the turn number one with the three of Floyd Self. Holding down the sixth and final transfer spot right now, the Jimmy Smith in the 117. First man on the outside looking in. Meanwhile, up front, the 21 of Maryville, Tennessee's Robby Moses showing the way here in the Double Down Motorsports number 21 machine. His teammate Shannon Buckingham in the lock-in, going to start 15th in the Frostbuster 40 here this afternoon. Andrew Littleton riding in the second spot. James Williamson holding down third. Levi Ashby again challenging Billy Ogle Jr. for the fourth spot off four down Main Street as they head off into turn one here at the 411, but not able to make a move on Ogle so far has been Ashby, as Floyd Self continues to hold down that sixth and final transfer position. Moses in control at the moment. Littleton second, Williamson third. Ogle and Ashby continue to mix it up for that fourth and fifth spot with Asheville, North Carolina's Floyd Self holding down the sixth and final transfer spot in this one. Yeah, it's a lap slowly slipping away from us here in this super late model last chance showdown event. And Robby Moses continuing to show the way out front. Young man has been nice and smooth throughout this one so far in the Tennessee RV Super Center Grand A Design, sponsored number 21. As we've got less than two laps to go now, is the field working down the back straightaway and into turn number three. Off of turn number four, the white flag in the air. One lap to go here in this last chance, the main event for the super late models here at the Frostbuster 40. Moses for the final time down the back straightaway, sets the 21 machine down, gets it back up on the bars off turn number four. And Maryville, Tennessee's Robby Moses, the winner of the last chance showdown, B main for the super late models. Andrew Littleton will come on second. James Williamson will finish third. Billy Ogle Jr. fourth. Levi Ashby will finish fifth. And Floyd Self will finish in sixth. The 7 of Brian Smith will bring that inside row up, and the 69 of Carter Miller will bring the outside row up. And race fans, those of you on the back straightaway, wave to your favorite driver and wish him Godspeed for the next 40 laps. And now we start to get them into true four-wide salute to you great race fans. CT Promotions and 411 Motors Speedway presents the second annual Frostbuster 40 here at 411 Motors Speedway. Race fans, here they are. 40 laps, $3,500 up for grabs to the winner. And John Ownbey in the A19 and Jason Welshan in the 29 will pace the field when they bring them to green here momentarily. And the field getting the one to go with the line signal. We're coming to green next time by. We get set to come to the green flag, race fans. John Ownbey at A19, Jason Welshan in 29 to bring him to green. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's showtime. The drag race down the front straightaway and into turn number one. Welshan got a nose out in front and a lead him down the back straightaway. As they work off turn number four, Jason Welshan looks to lead lap number one. Cory Hedgecock's going to be in second. John Ownbey third. Here comes Donald McIntosh. He'll look to the inside of Ownbey for the third position. Off of four, along with the K37 of the milkman, Mike Weeks. They're thinking about getting three wide in the center of three and four. They will be three wide off four for the three spot. And Ownbey going to hang on to it for the time being. Welshan sets the pace with last year's Frostbuster winner, Hedgecock, in second. But we got a four-way dance now as Dakotah Knuckles has got in the fray. Four cars battling for the third spot. McIntosh fires a slider. He'll try to grab the third position away from Ownbey. Down the front straightaway and into turn number one. He'll have that done. Knuckles is going to slide up the racing surface. That's going to clear Weeks for the fifth spot for the time being. But Knuckles gets a good run off the top side of two. Closes back in on Weeks for that fifth spot off four as they drag race down the main straightaway here at the 411. Meanwhile, Jason Welshan continues to lead the way out in front. He's got about a half a straightaway over second place, running Cory Hedgecock and about that much back to Donald McIntosh, who rides third. Mike Weeks in the Kennedy Motorsports K37, starting to flex some muscle now. He'll take the fourth position and move pole sitter John Ownbey back to the five spot. Dakotah Knuckles is six. Michael Chilton rides in seven. Stacy Boles, eight. Steve Smith, nine. And Matt Henderson, the final car, in the top 10. As Welshan going to start the process of working slower traffic here in just a few laps. Young man with a great 2017 season going so far. Winterfest winner last weekend and showing away here in the early going of the 2017 edition of the Frostbuster here at 411 Motor Speedway. Welshan continues to lead the way with Hedgecock second, McIntosh third, Weeks is fourth, Ownbey fifth. Chilton now has made his way to sixth. Knuckles is seventh, Steve Smith eighth, Stacy Boles ninth, as the 12-year-old Carter Miller in the 69 works around the outside of Matt Henderson. He'll go to the 10th position down into turn number one. As Boles looks beneath the three of Smith, that is for the eighth spot down the back straightaway and into turn three. They're side by side, best battle inside the top 10 for position at the moment. As the 29 machine of Jason Welshan, as they will start the process of working slower traffic. Welshan steps to the outside. He'll put the three of Floyd Self a lap down. Next car he's got to set his sights on is going to be the 1A of Levi Ashby. And that's let Hedgecock close in on Welshan here just a little bit as the leaders are in traffic working through turns three and four. And Hedgecock gaining some ground now on race leader Jason Welshan. McIntosh holds down the four spot still. Or the third spot, excuse me, Mike Weeks in the K37 rides in fourth. John Ownbey fifth, Michael Chilton sixth, Stacy Boles and the Dakotah Knuckles going at it for seventh and eighth. Steve Smith ninth, Carter Miller 10th. He has a Welshan in traffic. He has got Hedgecock right on his back bumper as they roll off two down the back straightaway and hit toward turn number three right here. Hedgecock looking to the inside of Welshan for the lead off four. Welshan will cross over in front of him, try to work beneath the 19 of James Williamson and put him a lap down while Hedgecock rolls the outside. They'll go down the back straightaway and set him down into turn number three. The lap car, James Williamson, impedes the progress of Cory Hedgecock just a bit. As a Welshan clear of the lap car, but Hedgecock right on his back bumper as they race off into turn one and two. And Donald McIntosh has gained some ground on the lead duo as well, with Weeks holding down the fourth spot and John Ownbey still in fifth. Welshan in a gaggle of traffic right now as they race through turns one and two. He's working the bottom. Hedgecock taking the middle of the racing surface. Welshan trying to work beneath the last chance showdown winner, Robby Moses. He'll put him a lap down into turn number three while Hedgecock tries to roll the top shelf off of four to get a run on Welshan down the main straightaway. Yes, the leaders battle in traffic. The seven of Donald McIntosh has the rod and reel out and is reeling the front two in as they race off into turn number three. Hedgecock, he will jump to the high side here off turn number four. They made a little contact. Welshan will hang on to the top spot for the time being. And business may be getting ready to pick up at the point, but Welshan with a good run off the bottom side of two. Gets some breathing room for the moment. Puts the 87 of Andrew Littleton as a lap car between himself and the second place running machine of Hedgecock momentarily. And McIntosh has closed in on Hedgecock a bit as well, as a leader Jason Welshan tries to put the two of Mitchell Childress now a lap down. Childress and Clayton Turner in the 102 in front of race leader Jason Welshan now, as Cory Hedgecock trying to find a way around Jason Welshan, but it's been unsuccessful. But he gets a good run off the bottom of turn number two. Down the back straightaway. Close quarter racing for the top spot off turn number four. Welshan has it. Hedgecock wants it. Hedgecock going to try to dive to the inside of Welshan down in one, but Welshan will close the door on him. As they race off two, Welshan drifts up the racing surface. Hedgecock, again with a good run off the bottom, closes right up on Welshan's back bumper, but Welshan's going to lead him off turn four. He will put the slower car now of a Clayton Turner between himself and Hedgecock momentarily as they race into turn one and two. Welshan goes to the bottom, or middle this time. Hedgecock working at bottom, trying to get a run off the bottom side right there on Welshan's back bumper. This one's been a dandy up front, folks. Donald McIntosh continues to hold down that three spot. Mike Weeks is in fourth, and John Ownbey is fifth. Welshan and Hedgecock clear of traffic for the time being. The next car they will have to negotiate is going to be the 201 of Billy Ogle Jr. As Hedgecock went all the way to the rim up in three and four to try to get a good run down the main straightaway. But nothing doing there. It's McIntosh around Turner for, or he is third. He'll put Turner, a lap car, McIntosh trying to close in on second place. Hedgecock at this point in the contest. Yeah, and a Welshan now starting to reel in on a gaggle of slower traffic right in front of him. As they race down into turn at number three. Welshan goes to the top shelf off of turn four. Hedgecock follows suit. Welshan through the middle of one and two this time. Hedgecock still second, McIntosh third. All three of them on the same straightaway as they enter turn number three. Welshan trying to get a run off that high side to get around Billy Ogle Jr. and put him a lap down, and he may have him cleared this time as they work the bottom of turn number one. There may have been some contact, and Billy Ogle's gonna spin in turn number two. Caution and flag is out.
Thank you.
26 in the books, 14 remain. Jason Welshan in charge of the restart. Were the lines painted on the wall at up here in turn number four? Welshan set to call on him and brings the field to green off four, and here we go. Welshan will lead him off two. McIntosh, he's going to go to second here on this restart. Yeah, Welshan, McIntosh is looking to grab the lead from Welshan down into turn numbers one and two. He's got it momentarily, but drifts up the racetrack. Welshan trying to work back under him. Down into turns three and four. Who's going to have it at the line? Welshan will fire the slider back with 28 complete. McIntosh too close to call that time by at the line. Welshan got to hang on to the race lead, but McIntosh bringing the pressure to him. They're going to try to settle it amongst themselves. Now McIntosh pushed a bit in turn two. That gives Welshan a little breathing room. Hedgecock has settled into third. Weeks is fourth. Michael Chilton now in the 97's made his way into the top five. He rides in fifth. It's a lap winding down here in this one. And I believe unofficially we'll have 10 laps to go this time by at the line. Welshan continues to lead the way. McIntosh second, Hedgecock third. Weeks is fourth, Chilton in fifth. Welshan leads him off turn two, continues to show the way. McIntosh holding down the runner-up spot. Hedgecock third, Weeks fourth. Chilton is fifth, Ownbey sixth. Big shout out to the 12-year-old Carter Miller. He has made his way up to seventh in that 69 machine after starting 14th. The 12-year-old rides in seventh. Stacy Boles is eighth, Steve Smith ninth, and Shannon Buckingham the final car in the top 10. As the laps dwindling away now, Jason Welshan with a comfortable lead at the moment. He and McIntosh mixed it up on the restart, but it looked like Welshan just grabbed him another gear there after retaking the lead, losing it momentarily, but had it back at the line on lap 28. Welshan, and we got caution. Caution is out. We got caution and out for debris over in turn number three. They tell us debris over in turn number three. In third place, Cory Hedgecock's machine sets in the infield now. Chilton, Ownbey, Miller, Smith, Bowles, Buckingham, King, and Henderson all in tow off turn number four, and here we go. Welshan will lead them off to McIntosh second, Weeks in the third spot, Chilton fourth, Ownbey fifth, Miller getting some pressure from Bowles for that sixth spot, as we'll have four to go this time by at the line, four to go. Welshan working down the back straightaway in the Hitting Hollow Motorsports 29, the Blunt Motorsports 7, a McIntosh rides in second in the K37, the Kennedy Motorsports Longhorn of Mike Weeks rides in the three spot. Those three in the podium spots right now. Michael Chilton rides in fourth, John Ownbey fifth. Then it's Carter Miller sixth, Steve Smith seventh, Stacy Boles eighth, Shannon Buckingham ninth, as Ryan King and Matt Henderson go side by side for 10th. With just a few laps remaining here in the second annual Frostbuster 40. Less than two laps to go. We should be seeing a white flag at this time by. As the race leader, Jason Welshan, working off turn number four, he'll come to the white flag. One lap to go for the Maryville, Tennessee native. McIntosh with one final run, looks to the high side of turn two, trying to get a run on Welshan. Down the back straightaway, they'll go for the final time into turn three. McIntosh goes to the top shelf off of turn four. Jason Welshan will be the winner of the Frostbuster 40 here at 411 Motor Speedway. Donald McIntosh second, Mike Weeks will finish third, Michael Chilton comes home fourth, John Ownbey completes the top five. And race fans, he's about to make his way out of his Longhorn chassis. Give him a big round of applause, winner of the 2017 Frostbuster 40 out of Maryville, Tennessee, Jason Welshan. We'll get him around here, get a few words with him before they get the Victory Lane ceremony underway. Talking with runner-up finisher Donald McIntosh there. Step around here, Jason. First off, sir, congratulations. Two in a row now for you. Won the Winterfest last weekend. You guys have definitely hit on something other early here in 2017. You may want all these races to be daytime shows now.
Man, I tell you what, this Longhorn chassis, I'm really liking it. It's awesome. I got to thank Greg Martin for helping me put this piece together. Last weekend, I forgot to thank my wife, and we ain't been married that long, you can tell, but she's a very big part of this race car, and I've got to thank her. I want to thank Leanne Welsh, and she sticks with me.
Hey, talk about the race just a minute. Did you had that battle early with Cory Hedgecock there, got in traffic. Did you want to see that caution, or would you rather just stayed clean and green right there?
We went a little bit different on tires than everybody. So the caution really probably helped me, protect the right rear. But we gambled, and, it paid off for us. You know, I can't thank everybody enough at the shop. It helps me, Flat Top, Emily, Mom, Dad, Cecil, Gary, Roger, Hunter, the Competition Race Equipment, Hidden Hollow Motorsports, Ronald Sexton Construction, PPM, Randy, Ricky, Rodney at PPM, they've helped me a lot. Marshall Law, B&B Race Engines, this John LaFon engine under the hood there, and him and Lucas really strive to help us out here. And, everybody that puts this together for me, I could not do it without them. And all you fans for coming out, I really appreciate it. You all make this happen for us, believe it or not.
Hey, one more thing before we let you get the Victory Lane ceremony going. Talk about the restart there, round lap 26, 27. McIntosh fires a slider at you, one and two, but you weren't going to be denied. You just set up in the seat, got your handful of wheel, and returned the slider down in turn three and four. And it looked like you pushed him. You may have had to push your race car a little bit harder after that because you actually drove away from him in the waning laps of the race.
Yeah, I got a little bit lazy. I laid back there for just a little bit, and then when he got under me, I kind of put my elbows up and got back up on the steering wheel. But I was trying to protect my tire, too, but, you know, it's always fun racing with Donald. I hadn't had a chance to race with him a whole lot, but I think we got a piece here that we can actually race with these guys, and we can compete and run up front in some of these bigger shows. I'm real excited about this year. We didn't race a whole lot last year. Took some time off and done our homework, built a nice car, and I'm really looking forward for 2017.
Once again, give him a big round of applause. Jason Welshan, winner of the Frostbuster 40.
I want to thank Mitch McCarter and his staff for doing all the hard work that they put in this racetrack. I know firsthand how much work it is to put this deal on, and my hat's off to them.
And we'll slide back here and grab a few words with our runner-up finisher, Donald McIntosh. And Donald McIntosh, second place finish in the Frostbuster 40. You've been down south doing some of the Speed Week stuff and decided to pack it in there after two rainouts, come back north to a little bit more familiar grounds, come home with a second place finish. Talk about your run today.
Man, I'm so proud of this team. We learned a lot down there in Florida. We didn't run real good many nights, but we learned a lot. They race so different down there than you do up here. And it helps your driving to drive on different stuff. But I can't thank this team, Taylor Watson, David Bryant, everybody that helps us. Stowers Cat, Massey Electric, Tennessee RV, Larry Garner, everybody. So, man, I tell you what, there is no other racetrack that you can race in the daytime and actually race on it. I knew I really didn't have anything for him, but I had to try it, so it's that was fun. I mean, for a daytime race, you couldn't ask for no better.
And I know you were trying to spin the tires up there, maybe get some heat in them during those cautions or keep them from getting sealed up. I noticed you didn't know if maybe you pushed the right front off a little bit. After that one restart, you traded the sliders right there. It looked like you was really having to labor with the race car a little bit off turn two, and that's where Welshan was kind of getting away from you there a little bit.
He had more traction coming off of two the whole time, so I knew my only chance was down there in three and four, and I got him here, but I just pinned him enough just to be like, I'm going to take it. It ain't clean, but I'm going to take it. So, that was a last-ditch effort, but the right rear was kind of sealing up a little bit after a few laps, so I was just trying to spin. We went on a hard tire and just trying to spin it up and see what we can get. But it'd go for a couple laps, and then it'd kind of seal up, and I'd have to make her push a little bit. But, you know, it was a fun race anyway.
Donald McIntosh, runner-up finisher in the 2017 Frostbuster 40. And our final podium finisher, young man that I haven't had the pleasure to see for a while, but finishing in the third position in the 2017 Frostbuster 40. Lenore City, Tennessee native Mike Weeks, better known as the Milkman. Young man, congratulations. You flat-pedaled this hot rod to a very impressive run today, and I know you got to be tickled to death.
Man, I'm just happy for this whole team here. Billy Kendi's given me a great opportunity here, and I can't thank him and Drew and my son, Brennan, and my wife back home. And this is just I don't get to race a whole lot anymore, but this guy's made me rejuvenate my racing career a little bit, and congratulations to Jason and Donald. Them guys have been good, too. I mean, Jason's been on a roll here lately, but just want to thank everybody for coming and watching this today, because if it weren't for you guys, it wouldn't even be worth coming out here and racing, because we're putting a show on for them guys.
And I know you do your last couple of seasons, you haven't been able to race as much as you've been wanted to. You've kind of done some different things, still kept yourself involved in racing, but maybe you can get these boys say, hey, I can compete with these guys. Y'all need to let me run this super deal a little bit more often, man.
I hope so. I mean, I'm just trying to help Drew, you know, come get a little better with this program. But I can't thank all the guys that help us. Wolfpack Racing, where I work, Chuck Smith, Randall Chuck. Like I said, GNW Towing, Superior Telecom, Schubert Monument, Vicchio Motors, Hoosier Tires, just everybody, man. There's so many people that help us, and I'm very thankful and blessed to be able to still be able to race a little bit.
Give him a big round of applause. Mike Weeks picking up a third-place finish in the Frostbuster 40.